Find out how you can get started with Docker and Azure in this edition of Azure Tips and Tricks. To get started with Docker on your local dev machine, you're going to have to install the Docker desktop application. First, head over to www.docker.com. Then select Products, and then we'll go to Docker Desktop. Here, you'll be able to choose the application for your respective operating system, whether it's Docker for Mac or even Docker for Windows. After you've downloaded the installation file and run through the setup, you should have a Docker icon living inside of your taskbar. So in my case, I'm using a Mac, so I have this whale icon that's available in my taskbar. Notice I have this green icon that's saying Docker is running. Now, another way that we could verify that Docker is running is to open our terminal. So here I have a terminal open, and I'll type the command Docker, and I'll type info. And this will give us some quick information about what's running on our machine. Another command that we can run is Docker version. Here we can see information about the Docker client and server that we have on our machine. Docker is all about images. If I type the Docker images command, I should be able to see all the images that I have running on my machine. Now, since I've had Docker set up and running already, I already have some images here. But if this is your first time running Docker, you're probably not going to see anything available on the screen. So the question is, where do I get images from? Now, you can either create your own images, or you can even pull them down from an image repository online. Let's head back to the Docker website. And if we go to Products and click on Docker Hub, it should take us to this website where we could search for various images. Here, I'm going to click Go to Docker Hub. What I'll do is I'll search for an ASP.NET Core image. So here I could see one that says Microsoft ASP.NET Core build. And I could browse this page to learn exactly how I can make use of this image. Now what I'll do on this right-hand side, I'll copy this Docker command that'll allow me to pull the image down to my local machine. Back in my terminal, I'll enter the command Docker pull and the name of the image I want to pull down. And in just a few minutes, Docker's going to reach out into that registry and pull down all I need to run that image locally here on my dev machine. The download is completed, so that means that if I type Docker images, now I should see that Microsoft/ASP.NET Core build image that we just pulled down from the Docker Hub. Now I should be able to take that image and create running containers here on my local machine. And that's how easily we could get set up and start working with Docker on our local dev machines.